Staying on the topic of cleaning, I went to go use my new-to-me Passap Vario yesterday, and it wasn't knitting properly. I lubed it, thinking maybe that was the problem, but it wasn't. Then I looked closely at the needles, and those were kind of dirty. So now I'm going to clean these needles. These needles are left 1, 2... Left 52 because there's 104 on each side of zero. So you want to separate the center left ones. If you have a standard machine, then of course you're going to do 50 needles each. And then when I put these back, these are going to go on the outside of the left or maybe the outside of the right. It doesn't really matter as long as I switch the center needles with the outside needles. But here I am with the mineral spirits. I have used denatured alcohol in the past. I ran out of it. And when I went to go look up the difference between the two, this one tends to evaporate a little bit faster than denatured alcohol. But you want to have some kind of degreaser, and this is a good degreaser as well. You want to have something that's going to be a good degreaser. Now, this is a oil, machine knit oil that I got from somebody special, and I use it, as you see. I actually got oil on the bottom, so I just took a paper towel around it, see, super lube, and just put an elastic to hold it in place. That way, I'll switch this out after it gets dirty, and I think you could kind of see it is already getting dirty. So now, with the jar, take any jar, and I think you could see that the liquid is clear. I hope you could see. I have to do this outside because you want to do this in a ventilated area. And I put the hook side down. Now, I'm right-handed, so I'll go ahead and turn the needles around like that. And then I'll even put it on its side and swish it around. And I could start seeing the liquid is getting a little bit darker now. Now you want to use the same glass, same jar. So if you mark it, mineral spirits or a knitting machine needle cleaner. Now I'm going to let this sit a little bit so that it could get in. And I'm not sure if you could see it, where the liquid is getting a little darker. It is cleaning the needles. And you want to make sure you got a tight jar on this too, a tight seal, because as you go sideways like this, if it leaks and you don't have your gloves on, and I have this on to grab the needles out. But just agitate it. You don't have to do too much to it, then let it sit. I'll come back in 10 minutes, take the cover off, pull the needles out. And then I have this little flat box here, and I put two layers of paper towel. And of course I have newspaper underneath that just in case. But I will lay each needle out in here. And as it goes, as they dry, it all evaporates. And that little bit of oil should stay within the latch. But what I will do is, after I take them all out, of course I'll have my glove on then, but I'll put a drop of the oil on my fingertip here, and I'll take each needle and I'll put the hook right in my fingertip and I'll rub it there to make sure I do get oil within that latch. So if you don't put oil in the cleaning solution, you can still lubricate up the latch later on. So here is the jar after the second set of needles. The other thing I want to point out is I will take the needles and put them in a Ziploc bag and label them. Now this has the thing to write on, but if not, you could put tape on it and write on it what needles they came from. So when it's time to put it back in the machine, you know where you're going to put them. Now this is after the third set of needles. I've got one more. I've had dirtier needles than this, but at least I know I am getting them clean. Now here it is after the last set. I got one needle that I think was bent, but I'm going to clean that one by itself and put it on the end. It was stopping the carriage from moving. Anyways, I could see a lot of gunk in the bottom of this, but in order for me to show you, I have to tilt the camera up looking at the ceiling and hold this above it. And there it is. All from a, what was it, 208 needles. 207 needles. Okay, I've got my flashlight on the end of this machine here. But I think you could see the dirt down in the grooves and also the yellowish, which is old grease or oil, on the machine. When I was getting to the end here and taking the needles out of this bed, I could hear the spring in there. So just like the DM80, there is a what they call a break spring. But what I need to do, I'm going to take this apart, but there's one screw here holding the end on, and it probably slides right off. There's two screws on each feet here for the clamp, and I'm going to get still pictures of this before I even do anything. So I think after I get the sides off, that back bar will come right off. But down in these holes, there is a nut. Just like in the DM80, if I loosen that up, then this bar here should just slide right out. I'll see that spring. I may have to replace that spring, but hopefully not. Then I'm going to take the bed sections and wash them in some nice soapy water, a toothbrush, soft toothbrush to get down inside the grooves there, and then put them out in the sun on a tilt so they could dry. And then make sure it's all dry before I put this all back together. So the only metal parts really is these two rails. The front parts, which I have off, those are plastic, although there's a rod, metal rod that goes in there. Oh, and the metal rod that goes in the side, the other side I think it is, yeah, that holds the needles down. I forgot to show the lint that's down in here. So there's some right there. There's another spot right in there. And I could probably just take a brush to get this out. But where I did see the dried grease over on this side here, I want to clean that up as well. So I was right. There was this spring in that channel there. But I noticed at the end of each section there's little teeth that held the spring in place. But these held these parts in place. And okay, here we go. So here's one part taken out, and I could take this to my sink and wash it, put it outside in the sun, let it be on an angle so that any water could drip down, get it nice and clean. I do need to get the other two sections off, and I probably got to take these off now so I don't lose the nuts. I put them back on these. I'm not sure what they're called, but kind of a bolt, but it has a different head. That head, just like the DM80, was inside the slot of this bar, and that's what held this bar down in place. So I'm going to get the other four off. I'm going to wash these four sections and see if the bottom part needs any cleaning. I was wrong. This back piece is part of the bed itself. Right here is just one piece, and it is plastic. But I could go ahead and wash these up, clean them. Now when I put them back together, I do have to make sure. And this is where I probably have to, before I even put them in, is slide them together and then push it down in place. Although it came up that way, so I could probably just go like that. Anyways, I'll get this nice and cleaned up, and I'm sure it's going to be working a lot better once it's clean and lubricated again.